And then drawing your body up nice and tall. Just relax your arms down by your side or on your lap. And just take a nice deep breath. In through your nose. And slowly breathing out of your nose. Take a nice long deep breath in. Breathing all the way back out. Taking a long deep breath in. Breathing all the way back out. And then this time, take a long deep breath in. And then gently drawing your chin down in towards your chest and holding on to your breath. And then raising your chin back up, breathing all the way back out again. Taking a long deep breath in. Gently drawing down your chin, holding on to your breath. Just trying to keep the shoulders relaxed. Just let the body relax. It will stay warmer if you can relax it. And raising your chin back up. Breathing all the way back out again. And this time, take a longer, deeper breath in. Back up and breathe in. One more time, breathing out as completely as you can. Once you get to the bottom of your exhalation, try to breathe out a little bit more. Lower down your chin, holding your breath out. Raising your chin back up and breathing in. And breathing out. Now just take another couple of deep breaths in and out there for me. Try and control the breathing. Clasping your fingers and raising your arms to come high above your head. Take a deep breath in. As you breathe out, let's take a small rotation with your upper body. Breathing in, breathe back to the middle. Breathing out, a little rotation with your upper body. Breathing in back to the middle. And then breathing out as you bring the hands all the way back down to the floor. Coming up to lift and sit back up onto your heels. And then just reaching right up towards the top end of your mat. And lifting your chin and starting to draw your body slowly up and along the ground. Rolling down the shoulders and lifting the chin. And let's curl the toes, press back up into your downward dog, and look up towards your navel. Drawing forwards into a high plank, and then bending with your knees, and sitting all the way back. Let's breathe in as you draw up and along the ground. And then breathing out as we send the hips back and draw the head down through your arms. Breathing in draw forward to a high plank. Breathing out as you bend your knees and sit all the way back. Okay, let's breathe in, pull your body up and through. Breathing out as you lengthen all the way back off into that long downward dog. Breathing in, draw forward to a high plank. Breathing out as you bend your knees and sit all back. Breathing in, drawing the body up. Breathing out to lengthen all the way back, long downward dog. Breathing in, forward to high plank. Breathing out to bend your knees and sit on back. And draw the body up. And again, don't worry if you're not staying very low to the ground today. Breathing out, sending the hips back. And don't worry if the heels don't touch back. Breathing in, draw forwards to plank. Breathing out, bend the knees and sit back. And just notice where you are. And then notice if things change as you begin to get stronger. Push up into downward dog. And as you begin to feel your muscles releasing. Breathing in, forwards to plank. Breathing out, sitting all the way back. Back one more time. Breathing in, drawing the body up. Breathing out as you send the hips back. Breathing in, forwards to a plank. Breathing out, bend the knees and sit back. One more time, breathing in, come on up. As we breathe out, remaining in that downward dog. Let's just walk the feet from one to the other. Rolling the hips a little from one side to the other. Spreading your fingers nice and wide to the floor. Okay, now just leading the heels back as far as I go. Walking your hands back. And today, just taking a hold of your elbows. And then just make a little semicircle rock around your legs from one side to the other. Still relaxing the neck and shoulders. Still letting your head draw down towards your forearms. But just take a little rock from side to side around the front of your legs. And then release into the middle. And very gently as you unroll through your spine, breathing in. Bring your arms up at the top. As you breathe out, take a little side body bend, pushing away through the hips, ears and arms together. And breathing in, bring up. Breathing out, a little push out of the waist. Breathing in, bring back up. Breathing out, letting your arms all the way back down. All right, step it up to the top of your mat there for me. Hands in little heart. Let's take a deep breath in, raising both arms. Breathing out, open the chest as you fold forwards. Breathing in, take your right leg back behind you. Just let the knee fall down towards the floor, lifting your chin. Breathing out as we step the feet together and hold to a high plank. Breathing in, come down to your knees, your belly, your chest. Breathing out, gently draw into an upward dog. Breathing in as you lower. Curl the toes, engage the core. Breathe out as you push to a plank. Back off into a downward dog. Breathing in, right foot stepping through, lifting the shin and releasing the toes back. Then breathing out, left leg, lightly stepping up, folding to your knees. Breathing in as you pull up through the belly, open chest, gaze to your thumbs. Breathing out, follow your thumbs back to your heart. Breathing in, raising arms. Breathing out, fall forwards. Breathing in, left leg, stepping it all the way back, releasing your knee, lifting your chin up. Breathing out, let's step back and hold into a high plank. Breathing in, draw down to your knees, your belly, your chest. Breathing out, floating into an upward dog, not too much pressure. Breathing into lower. Curl the toes, engage the core. Breathing out, push the plank. Back off into a downward dog. Breathing in, left leg steps through. Lift the shin, releasing toes. Breathing out, right leg steps through. Take a nice deep breath in as you come all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, pass back to your heart. Breathing in, let's raise our arms. Breathing out, diving the body forwards. Breathing in, right leg stepping back. Now just leaving the knee down upon the ground there for me. Come back on up with your upper body. Now just starting to work a little bit more range out into the shoulders. Take the right arm up and just drop it back behind your head. Now here, you can either take your left arm and gently encourage that arm downwards into a tricep stretch, or you can reach back round and find your fingers. So either will work. We're just opening up, lifting the shin, feeling that stretch along the upper back of your arm and your hip flexor. And releasing your arms. Moving back onto the back knee, dig your heel in, and draw your toes back. And now here, either remain, or take your right hand over the top, and start to work your fingers a little bit further across. So we're going to stretch into the calf and the hamstring, just a little bit more work coming into the lower back on the right hand side. Just bring it back on round. Work your foot forwards into the ground again. And let's slide the feet together behind you. And then we're going to come down onto your forearms. So we're going to come down into a plank. So if you can, come down with both elbows at the same time. So float back, elbows down, looking beyond your fingers. 10 breaths here for me. Deep breath in and out. Pilates breathing here, in through your nose, out through your mouth, and engaging your core, pull your belly up. Deep breath in, and out three. In, out four, pulling up on your bottom rib. In, out five. In, out six. In, out seven. In, out eight. In, out nine. In, out, and gently lower yourself back down to the floor. And let's from here, just bring your arms down by your side. Let your shoulders draw down, coming into the breast stroke. So relax the legs. And again, another Pilates posture as you breathe in. Roll back both of your shoulders. As you breathe out, engage your core to lift and hover, looking down at the floor. Breathe in to stay. And breathing out as you lower your shoulders back down. Breathing in, shrug back and down with your shoulders. As you breathe out, draw the belly back as you raise and hover. Breathe in, keep the core locked on. And breathing out as you lower your shoulders back upon the floor. Breathing in, rolling back and down with your shoulders. If you can, rotate your hands open. Breathing out to lift and hover. Breathing in to stay. And breathing out, shrugging your shoulders back upon the floor. Breathing in, shoulders rolling back and down. Breathing out, engaging your core as you lift. Breathing in to stay. Breathing out as we lower the shoulders all the way back down. One more time. Breathing in, shoulders roll back. Breathing out to engage the core as you lift. Breathe in to stay. And breathing out as you lower all of the way back on down. Take the hands just back up underneath your shoulders. Gently draw up into your upward dog. Deep breath in. And as you breathe out, lower back. Curl the toes, engage the core. Breathe in, push up to plank. Breathe out into a nice long downward dog. Okay, now we can step your right foot back behind your left. Bend your left knee and draw your right heel a little firmer into the floor. So we should get a stretch here for the lower back upon the right hand side, little bit more range into the calf and the hamstring. And then let's swap it over. Taking your left leg back behind your right, bending your right knee, and pressing your left heel a little more into the floor. So the side by side, and then looking forward, step your right foot up between your hands, and then release your left knee down upon the floor. Let's step through with your left foot also, and take a nice deep breath in, all the way back out to standing, breathing out, hands back into your heart, breathing and raising both arms. Breathing out, big dive forwards. Breathing in, left leg. Step all of the way back. Releasing the knee down upon the ground. Bring the upper body back and open. And then raising your left arm. Dropping it back behind the head. And you can from here take your right arm, just gently encourage it down. Or reach around and take a hold of your fingers. Keeping your chin lifted, okay, find a stretch, tricep stretch. Letting your arms go, moving back upon the back knee, digging the heel in, drawing the toes back. And if you can, take your left hand over, working your feet, or fingers, sorry, away. And drawing your toes back a little bit more. Okay, walk it back over. Land your foot back down upon the ground. And let's curl the toes and step the feet together behind you. And then I'd like you to just come down upon your knees. Place your hands beneath your shoulders, take a deep breath in, and as you breathe out, extend your right leg, press it up and away from you, and then breathing in, draw the knee back in and change. Breathing out, take your left leg away, and breathing in, draw back in and change. Now at this point, when you take the leg away, I want you to try and keep the balance of your hips stable. Breathing in. Pull up on your bottom rib, and as you take the leg away, draw the navel back to the spine. Breathing in as you lower. Again, breathing out to press away. Breathing in to draw back in. Breathing out to press away. Breathing in. Now, I'm going to do a couple more, and then I'm going to take you up a little. And if it feels too much, come back to the single leg raise. All right, that would be fine. Now my next offering is that we take it into a leg circle. So we take the leg away, and as you breathe out, take the leg up. On your downward circle, breathe in. Breathing out, circle, breathing into lower. Now if you're having a really good day, circle the opposite arm as well. So breathing out. I want you to imagine that your whole body is encased in like a thick syrup. So you want to just move really slowly and smoothly. Breathing out and in. Keeping that core locked on. Breathing out. And in, one more time, and then land the hands and the foot back down. Take the opposite leg away. Breathing out as the leg goes up, breathing in as it comes lower. Breathing out, and in. And just again, keeping the balance through the body, taking the opposite hand away too, if you'd like to, and circle. And again, like we did before, nice and smoothly, try and imagine that you're circling on the wall behind your back, right behind your body. So not too much out to the side. And again, same thing with your arm, nice and smooth. forearm across the top of your mat. Left fingers down towards the floor. Let's take a deep breath in, rise up onto your forearm. As you breathe out, look over your shoulder. So you may be able to see your left foot, you may be able to see both feet. Don't worry if you can't, it might happen. And gently bring that round, swapping it over. Fingertips down, take a deep breath in, rise up. As you breathe out, gazing over your shoulder.
Just when you're ready.
So bending the knee now deeply, clasping your fingers to come back behind you and drawing your shoulder towards the inside of your knee and looking back towards your back foot. Coming into your humble warrior. Inhale, take some deep breaths, releasing the neck and shoulders. And drawing the body back a little. And let's land your right arm beneath your right leg, finding your fingers. And if you'd like to, wiggle back up your left foot and place it next door to your right. So you've got a parallel squat. Going further, if you wish to, push hard into your left foot and then slowly come back up to standing. Shoulders roll back. Maybe extending the leg a little higher if you'd like to. Bending your knees, slowly coming back down, stepping back with your left foot, and then taking both of your hands to the inside of your foot. Now rolling onto the outside edge of your back foot, coming into a side plank. Either take your right foot so it sits in front of your left, or take your right big toe with your first two fingers of your right hand, and maybe take your right leg up towards the ceiling. And stepping your foot all the way back round to the top of your mat. Let's now step back in your back leg, half of your stride. Have a look down, so getting your heels line up. And bring your body up to about halfway. Now from here, press back into the back foot, sway your hips off to the short end of your mat. Either take your hands back to a back prayer or hold on to your elbows today. Either way, fly your elbows off the sides of your body. Lifting chin, either remain with halfway or lower your chin towards your shin. And again, take some deep breaths in through your nose. Out through your nose. Okay, and gently moving it up into warrior three. Looking forwards, take your body weight forwards and lift your back leg. Now keeping your hips level. Keeping your back leg, if you can, in alignment only with your upper body. Try not to go any higher. Breathe. Okay, then taking down both of your hands to the floor. And either remaining, pointing your toes down your back leg, or leaving your right hand diagonal angle just off from your left or right foot. And then bring your left hand up to the ceiling. Point your toes, open your hip. And slowly let that hand down. Draw your feet in together. Tuck your head in towards your knees. As we unroll, breathing in. Raising your arms high, and as you breathe out, hands back in towards your heart. Okay, now coming into a couple of bounces just to release the muscles along the right-hand side of your body. Now if we could just pick up the right leg and place it above or below your knee, coming into your tree position. And this will give us a little bit of relief, okay, having just worked those muscles really hard. Hands in your heart. And then slowly working the fingers up through the midline. Now taking your right hand about behind the left if you can. And take some deep breaths. In through your nose. Out through your nose. Okay, now letting down your right arm, taking a hold of your right foot, half forward to counter, and then bring your right leg up behind you into the dancer. And slowly bring it up. Now just coming into flying pigeon and not landing. So just flexing out the foot, sending your hips back, keeping your wings open, and pressing your chest upon your calf. So just really enjoy that stretch coming through your hips and your glutes. And slowly raise it back up again, keep your arms as they are, and take the leg out, hold it away from you, breathing in, breathing in and out, lower the leg back down again. Bring yourself up to the top of your mat. Take a deep breath in, raising both arms. Breathing out, open the chest, fold forwards. Breathing and step back with your right leg, leaving your left leg at the top. And let's just place down your left elbow to your left knee. And then circle the body with your right arm. Just looking back behind you. Open up the shoulder, the neck, and then deep breath in through your nose, out through your nose. And then, now, like I was saying, you can remain with the elbow on the knee. We could take the hands, the right arm up and across towards your ear. We could take your left hand to the floor. Again, just see what feels comfortable. Try to keep your arm in alignment with your body so the arm doesn't come too far forwards. And then you're gazing upwards towards your thumb. Palm is facing downwards. Deep breath. Body's open. Just keep that breath work going. Let the arm come around the front body. Pushing hard through your left leg, come on up into warrior two. Okay, tuck the tailbone under, have a little glance down. Can you see your big toe? If you can, go a bit deeper. Open up back with the shoulders and the chest. Little collarbones open, the neck is long. Deep breath in, breathing out, coming into reverse warrior. Looking towards your upper hand. If you wish to straighten the front leg, balancing up on the heel. And then placing the foot down, keeping the leg straight. Bring the body back up. Take a deep breath in. And inch the body out towards the left. And then take your left hand down to your left leg, lightly, looking up towards your right thumb. So if you're touching down with your right hand, try not to grab your leg. Try and reach softly along. Try not to let your hip roll forwards. Try to keep the ribs and the hips on the same line. Breathe in through your nose, out through your nose. Release. And then coming back, pushing your body weight, that back over onto your right foot, and slowly lifting your leg. Then you're aware, extending the leg a little, wherever your body will give you today. Breathe in through the nose, out through the nose. And then bend the knee, slowly bring it back down, stepping back with the right leg, take both hands to the inside of your foot. Roll to the outside edge of your back foot. You can either stack your feet up, so you take the left foot on top of your right or the front, or first two fingers around your every toe. And let's pull it up from the floor, press it up to the ceiling if you can. Again, remember it doesn't need to be perfect. You just need to breathe, just need to have a go, just need to keep moving. And then bring that leg all the way back round and place it back at the top of your mat. Let's bring your back leg in half of your stride. Have a little check down, see your heels are on the same line. Alright? We're going to come up halfway. And again, just doing your best. Feel around the hips. Do they feel pretty square to the end of the mat? Or as good as they're going to be for you today? That's okay. Let's bring the hands back behind, either coming into a back prayer or hold your elbows. And then from there, either hold out to halfway or extend a little out from your waist. Try and have an equal balance between your feet. Try not to front load too much. We do tend to want to do that with this posture. Keep breathing. In our mind, we're thinking of the next transition. So we're just gently moving it up into that left leg. We're floating ourselves up and letting the back leg come up. Flexing the back foot, hips facing the ground. Keeping lift the leg as straight as you can. And then drop both of your hands down. Either remain pointing your toes down, pushing through the toes, or bring up your right arm, leaving your left hand on the floor. And if you can, returning your gaze back up towards your right hand. And slowly let your hand down, bring down your right leg, fold against your legs. Take a nice deep breath, come all the way back out to standing. Breathing out, hands back in, and your heart. Alright, letting your shoulders down again. Now let's pick up that left foot, go above or below the knee, encouraging the knee to open back, hands in your heart, and slowly moving the fingers up through the midline. And then just taking your left hand back behind your right. Breathe, bring that breath back. Bring the core connection back from the navel back to the spine. And letting down the left hand. Taking a hold of your left foot. Knees together, and then as we go back, foot coming backwards and upwards. And then slowly bring it back in, coming into your flying pigeon, flexing the foot, sending face in front. We're going to put us down, getting ready to come up into crow. By all means, come down in a different way if this is not pleasant on your knees currently. So coming up, breathe in. As you breathe out, lower down. Take your hands to the floor in front of you. Remember, gazing up, okay? Look beyond the end of your mat. Soften the elbows. And either take your knees to squeeze the outside of your arms or going up underneath your armpits, either way. Leaning forwards. Finding a little bit of balance. And then gingerly taking either one foot or both feet off the floor.
Breathing out to lift
So very similar to a side plank, only that we have this oblique bending. And the arm, when it goes over, is really stretching the oblique muscles over the top. And then slowly coming back down. All right, last one. Breathing out as we lift. And breathing in as we lower. And then switch it around the other way. So laying the other way around, or just rolling yourself over, dropping your head up. Let's just bring the legs to come slightly forwards of your body. Top there coming up to hip height. Breathing and flexing the foot as you come forwards. Breathing out, pulling the toes as you go back. Breathing in to raise the leg up. Breathing out as you lower the leg down. Circling the leg nice and slowly. And again, just notice which way you started. Breathing in. Flex your foot down, then point your toes, circle the other way around, okay, maybe it's a little more tricky, maybe the leg doesn't make very good circles, maybe they're more oblong, that's okay, breathing in, and out, and let's start again, breathing in, coming forwards, breathing out, point your toes all the way back, breathing in, raise the leg up, breathing out, lower the leg down, point your toes, circle the leg. It will be the easier way this time. Breathing in and out. Last time, breathing in, coming forwards. Breathing out as you go back. Breathing in, raise the leg up. Breathing out, lower the leg down, point the toes, circle the leg a hard way. Make the circles generous. Breathing in and out. Okay, come on up. Elbow coming underneath your shoulder. Knees popping forwards of your body. Open back with your chest. And again, the easier, more manageable level will be on the elbow and side of the knees. And then as we come up, breathing out, we're reaching up and over. But the work that we take for the oblique muscles, that middle range of your body, that's going to be the same on both levels. Okay, you go up onto your hand. Make sure that the bottom leg, the foot hooks behind the leg that you're going to push down into. Okay, and then when we come up, keep your body facing forwards. It's quite common with this one that people want to tip themselves forwards and look down at the ground. Okay? Try not to do that, because as soon as you do that, your weight is going forwards and you stop getting into that lovely side bend work for the back. All right, because you really want to bend out from the waist, breathing out, we lift and snap the legs up together, breathing into lower. Benefits of this, you've got lovely weight strength work coming through the shoulders. You've got that lovely bend work coming through for the back. It's working the oblique muscles and obviously your core. Finishing that last one off and coming all the way back down. All right. Let's pop ourselves around onto your back. So, nice little opportunity to roll back, of course. So deep breath in. And as you breathe out, slowly taking your body back. Vertebrae after vertebrae. Okay, now let's just bring your feet back up to the ground and coming into your shoulder bridge. So be able to reach your heels with your fingertips. Take a breath in to prepare. And as you breathe out, work your lower back upon the floor. Peel the back away from the ground. Draw energy up through your thighs towards your knees, but try and relax your buttocks. Breathing in, and then breathing out as you lower your back down, vertebrae after vertebrae. Breathing in, as you breathe out, imprinting your lower back, peeling and The back comes away from the ground very smoothly. Push energy up into your thighs. Breathe in, breathe out as you lower. Now on our shoulder bridge that we use in Pilates, we look to keep the ribs into the body. Deep breath in. As you breathe out, drawing up onto your shoulders and your feet. The ribs are in, and you've only got a neutral lifted position. Breathing in and out as we lower back down. Unlike our yoga version, where we do go into more of a back bend. Deep breath in. As you breathe out, peeling up. So trying to control this lift coming out from the core. Breathing in. And breathing out as we lower. Okay, you can continue as so, or I'm just going to stay up for a couple of repetitions. So the next time I'm coming up, and as I stay at the top, lifting one heel and breathing out, lowering, lifting the other heel, breathing out, breathing and lowering. Now, if you place your fingers just lightly upon your hip bones, and when you lift the heel, I want you to imagine you can draw all those hip bones together. So maybe shut your eyes, and as you breathe out, pull in deep behind the surface muscles. So as you lift, breathe out and pull in, breathing into lower. Buttocks are completely switched down. We don't need those. And again, breathing out, engaging the core. Breathing into lower. Again, breathing out, engage the core. Into lower. One more time. With the feet down, take a breath in. And breathe out, lower your back all the way back down. Okay, now today, walk your right foot out to the side. And drop your right knee into the middle. Take the outside edge of your left foot to the side of your right knee and let both legs draw down. Take your right arm up and then hold on to your right wrist with your left hand. And try and let both of your knees draw a little bit closer down towards the floor. Slowly come back on up, walking your right foot back to the middle and then walking your left foot out to the side. Drop your left knee into the middle and take the outside edge of your right foot to the side of your left knee. So both knees are drawing in the direction of the right hand side. Let's reach up and hold on to your left wrist with your right hand. And then again, just try and relax the leg as much as you can. And then gently, let's untangle. Feet back down to the ground. And gently roll yourself across to one side and then back to seated. Okay, find your seated position of your choice. And then just taking your opposite arm across to your opposite knee, lengthening and looking over your shoulder. And then go around the other way. Nice big turn, looking right up over your shoulder.
Go the other way, lean out from your waist, hit the front straight.
more time. Lengthen, tilt the body forwards, reach all the way around, take the hands back behind you. Roll it down through your shoulders and just look down towards the floor. Taking your head across to one side. Feel that stretch along the back of your neck. Breathe through to the middle. Take your head across to the other side. As you come up, breathe in. As you look back,